Assalamualaikum and a very good day to Dr. Tuan Yusof. I am Wan Amir Ashraf and today I will explain on lab 3 that cover chapter finite control volume analysis, and the experiment that I will explain is impact of jet. Okay, for the introduction part, a jet of fluid may exert force on objects in contact with it. Finite control volume is used to analyze the fluid. The force will be determined by the use of Newton's second law or momentum equation. The force produced is due to the change in momentum or impulse that takes place as the jet strikes the surface. The study of this reaction force is a prerequisite for understanding fluid mechanics, which can be applied to hydraulic machinery like the Pelton wheel to produce power and the impulse turbine. Firemen also use this concept to extinguish fire on tall buildings. For this experiment, we will use a flat vane and a hemispheric vane to apply this concept and study about the force produced. Now let's move on to the theoretical part. The law of momentum conservation states that the summation of all externally applied force on a given volume is equal to the rate of change of momentum brought in the direction of forces. In order to calculate the force caused by impact of jet on a flat plate, principle of change in momentum is applied, where the equation is summation of fx equal to rho q v in minus v out, where summation of fx equal to summation of force in x direction, it can also be in y and z direction. Rho is density of water in kilogram of meter cube, q is volumetric flow rate in liter per second, and v is velocity of fluid in meter per second. The volumetric flow rate is calculated by taking volume of fluid within a time interval by using the formula q equal to v over t, where v is volume of water in liter and t is time in second. There are two objectives of the experiment. First is to determine the amount of force required to keep a flat plate at a certain level while being subjected to the impact of water jet. Next is to compare the value of calculated force with theoretical value. Let's move on to the procedures. There are 6 steps that need to be repeated because we will repeat this experiment using the flat vane and also a hemispheric vane. Okay, figure 1 here shows the setup of apparatus. The apparatus needed are level gauge, target plate, nozzle, adjustable fit, inlet pipe, nerve screw, weight pan, and spring. Okay, let's move on to the results and its end calculations. Table 1 here shows the result for flat vane. Here, we use different value of volumetric flow rate. Table 2 shows results for hemispheric vane. The hemispheric vane is also repeated using different volumetric flow rate. From the both of the result table, we obtain a force table. And from this table, we can see that there are slight difference in value of theoretical force and calculated force. This figure shows sample calculations for flat vane, and this is only applicable to theory 4. We use all the equation from the theory part. Okay, this figure shows the sample calculations for hemispheric vane and only applicable to theory 6. For the discussion part, the value of force F1 obtained are calculated from this equation, which is summation of Fs equal to rho q v in minus v out. On the other hand, the value of theoretical force F2 are calculated using this equation, F equal to Wd, where W is weight in Newton and d is distance of the key. V in are calculated from V in squared equal to Vn squared minus 2gs, where Vn is equal to velocity at nozzle in meter per second. For V out, it's different for both cases since they have different angle. We know that V out is equal to V in cos theta. So for flat vane, theta is equal to 0. So V out is equal to 0 since cos 90 is 0. For hemispheric vane, theta is equal to 180. So V out is equal to negative Vn since cos 180 is negative 1. For the conclusion, the force from a jet can be calculated using the momentum equation from the experiment. We know that as the flow rate increases, the greater the value of force from the jet. So, force is directionally proportional to flow rate. Slight difference may be caused by losses in apparatus, but the value only leads to a very small percent difference, which means that this experiment is reliable. That's all from me. Thank you.